Afternoon, everybody. Thank you very much for joining me. Yeah, there's still quite a bit of snow there at Yellowstone, and Old Faithful just went off. It was really a very short eruption. There was an earthquake a little while ago there at Yellowstone. It's not being reported by USGS. It probably came in as a magnitude 3.9 or a 4.0. When different people claim to be experts, and I'm no expert, reporting the activity at Yellowstone or around the world, they depend on what USGS and the other agencies report. And when they don't report them, they're not getting a full picture of what's going on. It's got a little bit of a P wave on it. Not quite sure where it occurred. It could have been there by a sawtooth. A lot of other websites also do videos to promote their products to sell. I don't get any support by promoting any products whatsoever. I only get an income from YouTube videos or donations. I figure if you're going to be selling products for other companies, you're probably going to be influenced by them, and I'm not going to be influenced by anybody. I downloaded data from the western boundary, Maple Creek, and also Little West Thumb. There's been probably 1, 2, 3 aftershocks. Here's the west. Oh, no, this is Maple Creek. This is Western Boundary. This is Little West Thumb. And up here at the top is Yellowstone Lake. That's by the fishing bridge. It looks like this earthquake might have registered there in Nebraska. Going to the heliopods. Is it going to load? Here we go. All right, let me bring it down. Down, yeah, you can see it right there. Okay, so going to the other monitors, looking through here. Let's see, there was one more. Yeah, convenient, Yellowstone Lake isn't working. And this monitor is for Nevada. Topia Springs, Nevada. Not quite sure if it's actually picking up the earthquake there. So we got one marked in red here at Maple Creek. And I'll make that one bigger for you. And all right, did I do this one? Yeah, I think I did. Okay, let me bring it down. Okay, it shows a 4.10. But it could be a little bit off. I might have made the seismic signature longer than it actually is. And I'll bring it over so you can see it. There's all the gases, hot gases and hot water that came up. And it looks to be fairly deep. You see down here. The first thing I did do is check globally to see if there was anything else going on. Look how it went small on me. It continues to go small. Yeah, there's nothing at this time that it could have been. I really doubt that the 5.3 that they had there in Greece picked up at Yellowstone. It was deep, though. You know, and that's why I went to the heliopods, 116 kilometers in depth. And see, it didn't show up on these monitors for like Oklahoma or Alaska, Arizona, Oregon, etc. So we got one aftershock. That's right there. It's a small one. That comes in as a magnitude 1.75. Okay, and then we got another one. It's a little bit bigger. That one comes in as a magnitude 2.31. And we'll take a look at these different earthquakes. We got quite a few here at Maple Creek. All right, we got 1735. That is universal time. That one is not being reported. It's a magnitude 1.34. Then we got another one marked in red at 1736. That one comes in as a 1.24. We got several up here at 1506. You can see, let me go to the signature. Will it be small? Okay, boom, boom. Here's the last earthquake they are reporting. At 15:07, they're saying it's a magnitude 0.7. Let's go to the seismic signature. I can't believe the ones they're reporting and the ones they're not. I mean, this is just so insignificant. It rattled on for a little bit. It's actually a magnitude 1.69. This one here they're reporting at 15:06 as a magnitude 0.8. It's actually a magnitude 1.30. Might be a little bit larger. But there's so many of them that they... Yeah. Okay, this is the western boundary. This is here, Maple Creek. Look at them all marked in red. And this one here is Little West Thumb. They've been having some deep earthquakes. You can see how far down the heat is that's indicating here. And this is what I was looking for at 15:26. It showed up on the stream view. And we'll go to the signature. Yeah, look at that. A sudden gush. You know, and that's what I think is going on. We got some of these deep earthquakes where the magma's probably trying to come up from the plume. Yeah. Those of you that have followed me, I've shown you how the Hunga Tonga volcano, when the magma started coming up through the mantle of the earth through the plume, it only took 1 hour for it to erupt. But there has been other volcanoes that have erupted within 10 minutes with no notice at all. Yep, 15:07. Everyone must have gone home after that because they're not reporting any of these other earthquakes. So I know it's been probably over a week since I reported about the earthquakes. I keep watching. I let you know if there's something significant. And yeah, so if I'm not reporting, you're not going to really have to worry. Yeah, because it could erupt within 10 minutes or an hour. And I showed you the documentation about how they're not really taking into account the rhyolite, which could come up super fast with no warning at all. I hate that when it does that. Okay, I'll go back over here. I believe that was on my last video about Yellowstone. Everyone needs to be prepared for any type of disaster. You're not children, you're adults. You should be doing that without me harping about it all the time or someone else harping about it. And if you don't and something happens, let's say we have a economic crash of the dollar. Let's say we go to war. Let's say there's a volcanic eruption or a very large earthquake. And you're thinking that, oh, someone else is going to help me. Yeah, good luck with that. So, thank you very much for watching. Thank you for subscribing. Always be safe, be prepared, and I'll talk to you later. God bless you all. Bye.